8-track Flashback gets disco fever with Donna Summer, The Tramps, Vicky Sue Robinson. Hi, I'm Leif Garrett, and this is 8-Track Flashback. During the next 30 minutes, we're going to hustle back into time and expose ourselves to a little disco fever. Disco celebrated glamour and fantasy and reigned as the predominant music of the 70s. Much maligned, okay, hated by the music establishment, disco was more than just a form of entertainment. It was a lifestyle, a set of its own moves, fashions, and stars. Perhaps the biggest star to emerge out of the disco era was Donna Summer. Before she became a disco superstar, Summer was a little-known singer living in Germany, and in 1977, Summer unleashed I Feel Love. The song was built on a hypnotic synth track and became a huge hit. It was also great to dance to, as Donna Summer demonstrates here by doing the robot on I Feel Love. Even by disco standards, Sylvester was an original. A flamboyant gay man who got his start in an equally over-the-top transvestite funk glam band, Sylvester was disco chic personified. A performer who could outrageous them all, Sylvester arranged his own music, designed his costumes and shows, and was blessed with a killer falsetto that enabled him to sing circles around most disco divas of the day. In fact, Sylvester, who was named Best Male Disco Performer by Billboard several times, had Sylvester Day, declared in his honor by the mayor of San Francisco in 1979. A year earlier, Sylvester scored his biggest hit with this slice of high-energy soul. Here's the incomparable Sylvester with You Make Me Feel Mighty Real. Yeah. dance floor's gonna be red hot when 8-Track Flashback returns with the Tramps.
You are having an 8-Track Flashback.
Welcome back to 8-Track Flashback. I'm Leif Garrett, and we're still burning up with disco fever. Up next are the Tramps, who first enjoyed success in 1965. Back then, they were the Volcanoes and sang R&B. But it was the rise of disco that made this Philadelphia group, renamed the Tramps, fully erupt. The 1973 hit Love Epidemic was a club fave. But in 1977, the Tramps recorded the song that became their biggest and most lasting hit. From the Saturday Night Fever soundtrack, here's the Tramps with their incendiary dance classic, Disco Inferno. In the 70s, disco may have reigned, but it wasn't universally beloved. In fact, some of the diehard rock fans saw disco's dominance as a sign of a cultural crisis. Scores of enraged discophobes took up the chant, "Disco sucks," catchy, no? And burned records in hopes of purging the world of the dreaded music that threatened to destroy life as we knew it. Looking back, the anti-disco movement could have been seen as racist and homophobic, since non-whites and gays made up much of disco's core audience. I think the root cause is even more sinister. These poor rock slobs just couldn't dance. Let's just take a look at the Disco Sucks movement in our flashback segment.
It's a 70s thing.
I thought disco music, for the most part, really sucked. It was disposable.
In the way that disco itself was created by America, it was also rejected by America. But they needed a scapegoat.
The whole disco sucks, you know, era was, you kind of took it personally. It was really, it was like the rock, white rock groups against the, kind of multicultural dance clubs. And it was like a little face-off.
I think it scared people when they saw Barnaby Jones dancing disco on TV and Ethel Merman singing it.
One of the biggest shows of the 70s was the Gong Show. Part talent contest, part public humiliation. The Gong Show was straight up tacky. Despite its popularity, you can count the people who went on to stardom after appearing on the Gong Show on one hand. Among them was disco diva Cheryl Lynn, who went on the Gong Show at the urging of her boyfriend. A dedicated gospel singer, Cheryl sang the only non-secular song she knew, You Are So Beautiful. The next day, Cheryl's phone lit up like a Christmas tree, and she was quickly signed to a record deal and recorded the song that would become a disco classic. Here's the ungongable Cheryl Lynn, who gets a perfect 10 for this song, Got to Be Real. Stay with us, Disco Disciples, because when we come back, we're going to hear from a singer who rearranged the rhythm.
I'm Vicki Sue Robinson, and you're having an 8-track flashback.
Welcome back to 8-Track Flashback, where we're reliving the days of disco when everybody boogied till they just couldn't boogie no more. I'm Leif Garrett. In 1976, our nation celebrated its bicentennial. While in the clubs and on the charts, disco celebrated its triumph over the folks who said it wouldn't last. Now, much more than urban phenomena, disco was mainstream, which turned the beat around made perfectly clear. One of the first disco songs to cross over to the pop charts, it earned singer Vicki Sue Robinson a Grammy nomination for Best Vocal Performance. According to Vicky Sue, her rise to success was literally overnight.
My mother was a folk singer, believe it or not. We sang at folk festivals, and then I was encouraged very young to audition for theater by my acting teacher in high school, and I did Hair on Broadway and Jesus Christ Superstar. And then all of a sudden I met a producer who said, "You're great." We went to the studio. I picked Turn the Beat Around out. It was the second release. I'd never been in the studio, and all of a sudden I was a disco queen.
Of course, you've all heard Gloria Estefan's cover. But here's the original disco national anthem as performed by Vicky Sue Robinson, Turn the Beat Around.
Turn the beat around. Love to hear percussion. Turn it upside down. Love to hear percussion. Love to hear it.
Whether you loved it, hated it, or simply chose to ignore it, there's no denying that disco revolutionized 70s pop culture. And although the ultimate 70s disco Studio 54 has been razed, and the hedonism of the 70s is a distant memory, disco's power to liberate can still be felt every time someone wants to shake one's groove thing. I'm Leif Garrett, saying thank you for watching 8-Track Flashback.